Hello friends, I welcome you all for the next video series. In this video, I am going to cover the topic of how to execute the Java source code. Okay, so using Java, we can create Java standalone application or applet program. So I am going to cover both the concept to execute Java standalone application and the applet program. Okay, so for this we have to install the editor like Notepad, which is by default available in a Windows platform, or other editor like TextPad, Notepad++. So I'm going to explain this concept of writing a Java code using Notepad++, because I'm going to execute this Java source code on a Windows platform, okay, using a DOS space. Okay, so I recommend you for a beginner, okay, we have to execute Java source code on console base instead of executing the Java source code on a different type of API like NetBeans, Eclipse, and different types of editors. The API are available, but I recommend you as a beginner you have to execute this Java source code on console base for better understanding, okay, or to get the deep knowledge of each and every one code which is available in Java. Okay, so start with the first program. Okay, so first of all I am showing you how to execute the simple Java application. Okay, so for this I have one simple Java source code. Okay, here I am created one class, name is an hello world, which simply display the three string, hello world, hi, and hi dear. These three string I am going to display on the console. So for this, after completion of this Java source code, you have to save this Java source file by the name, class name. There is a class name is hello world dot java. Okay, in any location. Okay, so I am saving this program on a desktop, writing the hello world as a class name dot java and then save it. Now after successful writing this code, you have to open the command prompt. Okay, by clicking on Windows button, then type the command prompt. Okay, so there is an option is available. Also there is another way, Windows key and R button, which simply open the run command, then write down the cmd, okay, and click OK. So here the DOS, the command prompt is open. Now we have to go to the path where the Java source file is saved. So as I have saved my Java source file on a desktop, so I'm going to change the path to the desktop. Okay, then first you have to compile your Java source file using the command Java C. So Java C is a Java compiler. Okay, then space, then what is the file name, class file name? Okay, your program name is hello world, okay, dot Java, then enter it. Okay, I am not getting any kind of error here. If any kind of mistake, syntactical error is in your source program, so in this console screen you are getting some error message. If the your source code is error free, there is no message will be displayed on the console screen. Now after successful compilation, you have to run this Java code by using Java interpreter. Okay, so write down the Java, then your class file name hello world dot Okay, there is no need to write on the dot class file. Okay, simply write the Java and hello world and then enter. So here we get the output hello world, hi and hi dear. So this is the simple output of this simple standalone application. Okay, now start with the another application, that is the applet application, applet Java program. So I have this simple applet program. We simply display a string welcome to Java class on a applet screen. Okay, so applet basically are the small Java program which are executed on Java enabled browser. Okay, so how to execute this program? This is the same procedure. First of all, we need to save this program by using class name. So class name is first and then first dot Java. Okay, so how to execute it? Okay, so first the same procedure, first compile it using Java C, then write the first dot Java. Okay, here the program is successfully compiled and our class file is created. As a class file contains the bytecode, always remember Java create the intermediate code. Java dot create the exe file directly, it will create the byte code. It is an intermediate code basically. Okay, so after successfully compilation, okay, to now after successful compilation we have to run the program. So how to run the applet program? For this we have to create one applet HTML file. Okay, so HTML file should be your file name, okay, source file name, Java source file name dot html. Okay, this is a simple HTML code which contains one applet code, then the code variable. For code variable we have to provide the path of a class file. Okay, Java class file. So my Java program name is first and the dot class file is an extension. Okay, and the applet size is 300 by 300. Okay, now okay, to run Java applet program, okay, to first of all we need to compile the Java source file. For this we have to type, okay, Java compiler, Java C, and then the Java source file name first dot Java. Okay, here, so successful compilation. After successful compilation we have to run the Java HTML file. Okay, applet file. Okay, to run the applet file or HTML file or applet program, we have to type applet viewer, then HTML file means first dot HTML. Okay, so here we get the output of an applet program. Okay, welcome to Java class. There is another way to execute the Java applet program, okay, by which, okay, so we need to copy this HTML file in the Java source file and paste here, and this whole HTML code should be in comment section. Okay, so in this program, okay, for execution of this program there is no need to create the separate HTML file. We can run the source file directly through the console. Okay, save it, then go to the console, then first compile it like first dot Java. Okay, then Java dot Java. Applet viewer dot first dot html. Okay, so this is another. Thank you so much.